Assalamu alaikum and peace be upon you, my brothers and sisters in scouting. My name is Scouter Irfan. I am a scout leader with the 392nd Thornhill Muslim Scouts, as well as a committee member of the Muslim Scout Fellowship Canada. We're really excited to have you join us today for our virtual campfire, and we'd love to see how you're settling in. Be sure to post your photos and videos on Instagram and Facebook, and tag us at Canadian Muslim Scout or hashtag Muslim Scout Campfire.
The Muslim Scout Fellowship Canada was established just last year in 2020 with the vision of promoting and supporting scouting within the Canadian Muslim community. Our fundamental mission is to bring scouting to the Muslim communities of Canada so that together our young people can develop into productive and beneficial members of Canada. If you are a scout or scouter of the Islamic faith who would like to be a part of the Muslim Scout Fellowship Canada, or if you're simply interested in learning more about the Muslim Scout Fellowship Canada, please reach out to us at msfcanada2020@gmail.com.
I'll now pass it off to the MSF Canada Committee Chairman to do the honors of igniting this virtual campfire. Enjoy the show.
Assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you. I'm Scout Ashfaq Naleem. On behalf of Muslim Scout Fellowship Canada, I welcome you to our inaugural event, MSF Canada's virtual campfire. May this fire touch us with the magic of its mystery. May we see in its dance the ever-changing beauty of the world. May this fire be good medicine where fellowship, adventure, and fun sit side by side. May this fire remain forever in our hearts. Even as the first fire kindled by our ancestors has remained alive through the ages, I declare this campfire open.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم صدق الله العظيم.
Assalamu alaikum everyone, my name is Maryam and I'm a venturer with the 163rd IIT Scout Group. I'm very happy to be your MC for this campfire and boy am I excited for all these performances. Sit tight, you're in for a real treat tonight.
Fire's burning, draw nearer, in the glowing, come sing and be merry.
Watermelons grow back to my home. I dare not go, for if I do, my mother will say,
"Have ever seen a whale with a polka dot tail down by the bay?
By the bay where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. Or if I do, my mother will
ever see a fly wearing a tie down by the way.
By the bay where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother will say.
Have you ever seen a bear combing his hair?
Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother will say.
Ever see llamas eating their pajamas?
Down by the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother will say.
Did you ever see an octopus dancing with a platypus?
Have
you ever have time when you couldn't make a rhyme? Down by the bay.
By the bay, where the watermelons grow. Back to my home, I dare not go. For if I do, my mother will say.
There are rats as big as alley cats at the store. There are rats as big as alley cats at the quartermaster store. My eyes are dim, I cannot see. I have not brought my specs with me. I have not brought my specs with me.
There are mice. Running through the rice at the store. There are mice running through the rice at the quartermaster store. My eyes are dim, I cannot see. I have not brought my specs with me. I have not brought my specs with me.
There are snakes. As big as garden rakes at the store. There are snakes as big as garden rakes at the quartermaster store. My eyes are dim, I cannot see. I have not brought my specs with me. I have not brought my specs with me.
There are beans as big as submarines at the store. There are beans as big as submarines at the quartermaster store. My eyes are dim, I cannot see. I have not brought my specs with me. I have not brought my specs with me.
There is gravy enough to float the Navy at the store. There is gravy enough to float the Navy at the quartermaster store. My eyes are dim, I cannot see. I have not brought my specs with me. I have not brought my specs with me.
So you take a big watermelon, you eat it all up, and then you spit out all the seeds.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm Adam, and you're watching my monthly Scouts project. For this month, I was assigned the Scouts Lookout project. This lookout should be strong and stable enough to support my weight and be at least 1 meter tall. In my case, it was a little less than 2 meters. First, I had to plan the building, which meant knowing the general idea of how the lookout would look. Then, I had to find the appropriate wood with the right measurements. Luckily, my brother's workshop had a dump with a lot of waste wood that I was able to use after we cut them all into the appropriate sizes. Another material was the rope, which I needed in a large quantity. So I decided to get them from Dollarama since they were cheap, and some from the Home Depot for certain parts of the structure. I started off with the ladder using the ladder lashing. I made sure the ladder was the most firm part of the whole lookout since it wasn't really supporting much. So I used the slightly stronger rope from the Home Depot and the thickest wood I had. Then I started building the main structure. The lashes I used for the main structure were two: the square lashing for all the corners and the diagonal lashing for the diagonal poles. A challenge that I faced was using the rope efficiently and not wasting a bit of it. At first, it was hard. And you can see a lot of the white rope is laying on the ground, wasted. But then I got a rough idea of how much rope each lashing needed by simply measuring by my arm's length and got a better idea throughout the building. After I finished building the lookout, I noticed some things that could have been improved and would have done differently. First, I noticed the pillars being slightly slanted, which could cause the structure to collapse if too much pressure was applied. This was probably because I worked alone and was struggling to keep everything straight. Second, if the structure as a whole could have been improved, I think a pyramid-like structure would be more firm and even simpler and easier to build than a rectangular prison. Building this lookout has taken me about 4.5 hours in total. It taught me a lot of things, including time management and taking initiative. It really opened up my mind and let me discover skills that I never knew I had. And I hope it does the same for you too. Thanks for watching and have a good one. Assalamu alaikum.
It's so great to see the scouters and youth working together in these performances. Teamwork is one of the most valuable things I've learned from scouting. Keep it up, everyone!
Yes, Furkan, what is it? Our meeting doesn't start until 3 and it's only 12 right now. You're 3 hours early.
Yes, I know, Brother Scouter Malik, but I'm so excited for today's scouting meeting and I just wanted to ask you a couple of questions about what I need to be prepared for. Will I be needing a hiking bag?
Nope.
Okay, how about flint and steel?
Nope.
Oh, how about a pocket knife?
Furkan, this is a virtual meeting that is taking place indoors. We are not going to any of that survival equipment. See you in 3 hours.
Welcome, everyone. Did the meeting start already? I'm sorry I'm a little late. I couldn't find my necker. Anyways, I was looking all over my room for it, but then I found it. See, great. Isn't the weather horrible outside? I'm so glad that we are at home instead of outside in the woods somewhere. Remember last year's 6-hour hike? It was such a torture. My feet were hurting, my fingers were hurting, I couldn't feel my face. That was totally too much.
Fatma, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I think you should get started with our meeting.
Oh, okay. Can I say something during the announcements? I have much to update everyone else on.
Sorry I'm late. I slept in.
Salam Hannah, how are you?
I'm good, just a little sleepy though.
Anna, wake up.
Oh, what happened?
Assalamu alaikum, Irfan, how are you? Irfan, we can hear you. Maybe you should fix your mic.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, we can, Irfan, but it's too loud. Is it possible for you to lower the sound, right? Maybe next time you should use another device.
Killing, yes, I got a 25 kill streak. Wait, oh, assalamu alaikum, guys.
Wa alaikum assalam, Adam. How are you playing games? You could hear the noise, okay? How are you?
Aw, oh, come on, seriously? I lost again. You're the worst teammate ever. Yes, I officially hate this game. Oops.
Assalamu alaikum, Mariam. Good to see you.
Wa alaikum assalam. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. Let's start the meeting.
You're disturbing my meeting. I'm going to tell mom. No, I'm telling her right now. Mom!
Oh, yeah, yeah. You know, I actually saw you in Hawaii. It was pretty cool. You know, you're like flying around and like shooting ladies. That's actually really cool of you.
Yeah. I saw you were doing a bunch of awesome stuff too, like boiling eggs on snow. How do you do that?
That's cool. Yeah. I mean, yeah, that's pretty cool of me. Yeah.
Who are you anyway?
Joe.
Joe.
Joe Mama! Alright. Anyways, yeah, I'm actually Abdullah from, you know, Free Safety Scouts.
What do you do in Scouts?
Anything my mom make me do.
What?
Anyways, what do you do? Yeah, what do you do?
It's pretty complicated to explain, but just to make things simpler for you, I make the world a better place by fighting bad guys.
Yeah, you know, I actually do that too, you know, I make the world a better place sometimes too.
How?
I pick up garbage sometimes, but you know, parts.
My company makes really cool stuff like this gauntlet. I have a bunch of suits, like my tower. I have like a self-driving car.
Yeah, you know, I actually made a car too once. Actually really awesome. You know, I did like a lot of work on it, you know. I mean, like my dad did help me with a little bit. Like, I mean, he just did like amazing time thing. Like, I wrote my name on it, the most of me. You know, it actually won like second place, like a really prestigious, you know, worldwide competition.
What competition is that?
Cup car. This it was cup car, really. Yeah.
Anyway, do you know how hard it is to fight bad guys?
Bro, I'm gonna be honest with you. Do you know how hard it is to have to poop in an outhouse when I go camping? The outhouse smells so bad. Like, bro, like, why do they make me do it? It's like torture, man. And then like we have to go on like 2-hour hikes and stuff, and like you don't even get a shower after, man. I smell so bad at the end of the day, bro. Sucks.
Okay. Anyway, I'm out of here now.
Alright, bye.
This story is called The Viper. There was a man who inherited a house when his uncle died. The house sat on a hill outside of town, and rumor had it that the old place was haunted. The man decided to move in straight away, despite his reservations. But late that night, the phone rang, and when he answered it, a creepy voice said, "I am the Viper. I will be there in 2 hours." And then it hung up before he could say anything. Not long after, the phone rang again, and a creepy voice said, "I am the Viper. I will be there in 20 minutes. And hung up. This made the man quite nervous, and he began to wonder who this mysterious caller could be. Before he knew it, the phone was ringing again. "I am the Viper. I will be there in 10 minutes. The man was getting much more concerned now. A few minutes later, the phone rang. "I am the Viper. I will be there in 5 minutes. Needless to say, the man began to panic. Again, the phone rang, and the man slowly lifted the receiver and put it to his ear. "I am the Viper. I will be there in 1 minute, said the voice. The man ran around, locking all the windows and doors, and then called the police. They told him that the officers were on their way. Suddenly, there was a knock at the door. Shaking with fear, the man opened the door a crack and asked, "Is that the police?" "No," replied the voice. "I am the Viper. I come every night to bash and wipe your windows. Where should I start?"
Moola moola ching ching.
All aboard!
Holy cow! That's the ugliest thing I've ever seen in my whole life.
What
George, how dare you say such a thing? You should be ashamed of yourself.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but just look at him. Yuck. That is definitely a face only a mother could love. Sheesh.
Oh, you beast, you beast. Conductor, conductor, come here.
Yes, ma'am? What's the problem?
This man is being rude and insulting and saying terrible things.
Sir, please move on to the next car and leave this woman alone.
Look, I'm sorry, but that thing is ugly.
There you go, ma'am. He won't bother you anymore.
Well, I certainly hope not. This has been an upsetting train ride.
Ma'am, this railroad does our best to keep all our passengers comfortable. Can I bring you a free drink from the hospitality car?
Oh, yes, that would be lovely.
While I'm there, I'll pick up a banana for that monkey of yours.
You know what really amazes me? Not only is Scouting full of people who love the outdoors and love being of service to their community, they're also full of other talents. Hasn't it been wonderful seeing the variety of performances so far? I can't wait to see more.
Assalamu alaikum, this is Kab Abdulrahman
and Scouting from it,
reporting from inside their kitchen. So today we'll be showing you how to make banana boats. Set the oven preheated at 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So, cut your banana.
Make sure you get help with the knife because it's dangerous.
And cut deep into it, but not for it to be able to poke out from the other side. Mm-hmm. Then you open it up from the inside. You get yourself the toppings and you slowly add them in there. So you stuff it with chocolate chips and marshmallows. Don't want too much. Then, once you're done, you get some foil and you wrap the banana in the foil. You can do it in an oven or microwave for a few minutes, and you can also do it on your campfire. So we're gonna wrap it up. You wanna keep it nice and tight. You wanna squish the banana. Everything is good. Now, quickly put it in the oven. I won't burn myself.
And while we wait for the bananas to finish, I'm going to make hot chocolate. This yields 4 cups. So I'm going to put in, we have milk here, 3.5 cups boiling. Okay. I'm going to add in 3/4 cup of sugar, third cup, of unsweetened cocoa, and a pinch of salt. Okay. You mix them until, mix them together. You mix the ingredients until they come to a boil. When it boils, you remove it from the stove. And add a teaspoon of vanilla.
Now the banana boats are ready. I'll take them out with the tongue and put them on and place it on a plate. So I will unwrap the foil right now. And since the marshmallows and chocolate chips have been melted, that's perfect. We can scoop it up with a spoon and drink it with our hot chocolate too.
Which I have prepared, put the vanilla on it. I'm gonna carefully just pour it on all in. And then you just put your marshmallows in and enjoy your campfire, inshallah.
Let's go, months in one by one, hoa, hoa. Let's go, months in one by one, hoa, hoa. The ants go marching one by one. The little one stopped to suck his tongue, and they all ran down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom.
The ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two. The young one stopped to tie his shoe, and they all go marching down to the ground, get out the rain. Boom, 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 boom.
The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three. The little one stops to climb a tree, and they all go marching down to the ground to get out the rain.
The ants go marching four by four.
Hurrah, hurrah.
The ants go marching four by four.
Hurrah, hurrah.
The ants go marching four by four. The little ones stop to shut the door. And they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain.
Boom, 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 boom.
The ants go marching five by five. Hurrah, hurrah.
Marching 7 by 7, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 7 by 7, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 7 by 7, and little one stops to pray to the heaven. The ants go marching 7 to the ground, off the rain. Boom, 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 boom.
Marching 8 by 8, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 8 by 8, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 8 by 8, the little ones stop to play the da-da. They all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom.
The ants go marching 9 by 9, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 9 by 9, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 9 by 9. The little one stops to check the time. The ants go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom.
The ants go marching 10 by 10. Hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 10 by 10. Hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching 10 by 10. The little one stops to shout the end, and they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 boom.
This story is called Appointment. There was a 16-year-old boy who got a summer job working on his grandfather's farm. One morning, his grandfather sent him into town on an errand to buy some provisions. The boy drove the pickup truck into town and parked outside the market. As he was walking along the street, he was jostled by somebody in the crowd. When he turned around, he was shocked to see it was the Grim Reaper, Death. As he stood there in the marketplace, Death beckoned to him. The terrified boy jumped back, ran back to the pickup truck, and drove back to the farm as fast as he could. When he got there, white-faced and trembling, he told his grandfather what had happened. "Let me take the truck," he begged. "I'll go to the city and hide. Death will never be able to find me there. It's the only way to avoid my fate." His grandfather told him he could have the truck, and the boy floored the accelerator and tore off at high speed. After he left, the grandfather went into town looking for Death. Eventually, he found the Grim Reaper standing in the crowded marketplace. The grandfather walked right up to Death and asked, "Why did you frighten my grandson when you saw him this morning? He's just a boy, only 16 years of age. He's too young to die."
"I'm sorry about that," said Death. "I did not mean to beckon to him. I was just startled. You see, I was very surprised to see him here in the marketplace. I have an appointment with him this afternoon in the city."
Go!
Oh, who are the people in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. Who are the people in your neighborhood? The people that you meet each day.
Hi, my name is Alia, and I am a doctor. The doctors make you well real quick if by chance you are feeling sick.
Hello, I'm a paramedic. When people are in danger, I come help them. Bye-bye.
Hi, I'm a pharmacist. My job is to check prescriptions. I prepare the medicine and give advice.
Hi, I'm Zidane, the firefighter. If there's fire anywhere about, I will be sure to put it out.
Hi, I am Mariam and I am a teacher. I will teach you important things that you won't forget, like the numbers and the alphabets.
Hi, I'm Zainab and I am a dentist. If you have an aching tooth, I can fix it quick. And that's the truth.
Hello, I am an air carrier, and I'm a frontline worker. I distribute letters in the neighborhood. Bye-bye.
Hi, I am Hassan, and I am a veterinarian. If your pet is in need and feeling sick, I will help it feel better quick.
Hi, I'm Sam. I'm a policeman. The policemen have a job to do to keep the city safe for me and you.
I am Ahmed and I am a secret agent. I work on special tasks for public safety and get information from the government.
Hi, I'm Ramesa and I am a baker.
A baker is the one who makes your bread and rolls and pies and cakes.
Go.
These are the people in your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood. Say these are the people in your neighborhood. The people that you meet when you're walking down the street. The people that you meet each day.
Did you know that virtual scouting is teaching us so much about technology? I've become an expert on Zoom, iMovie, Kahoot, Drawsaurus, and so many other online tools that I never would have used if there wasn't a pandemic. Just putting together a virtual campfire like this one is a technological feat in itself. Let's keep watching.
Was it a 4?
No.
Was it a 3?
No.
Was it a 2?
No.
Was it a 1?
Yes.
Wonderful.
Assalamualaikum, everybody. My name is Austin. My name is Saraya. And today we are going to make slime. What we'll need is 1 cup of clear Elmer's glue, food coloring, 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, which is also equal to 1.25 milliliters of baking soda, and contact lens solution.
Take a look at me, a penguin such as me. Penguin such as me.
Assalamualaikum. This is 163rd IIT Cub Scouts.
This is a repeat after me song.
This is a repeat after me song.
I said boom chicka boom.
I said boom chicka boom.
Oh yeah!
One more time!
Baby style!
I said boom chicka boom.
Yahoo!
Yee-haw!
One more time.
Dinner style. I said boom, chicka boom.
My name is Mustafa. Today I'll be telling you a joke. Here's the joke. Some boys from the city went camping. The mosquitoes over there were so fierce they had to hide under their own blankets. Then one of the scouts went outside of the tent and caught some fireflies. He came back and said, "We should give up already." Then he sighed. He said, "They're coming to us with flashlights now."
First day of CD production.
Yes, sir.
1, 2, baby. Boop, boop, boop.
Rob just wanted to chip out how times have changed. Can't cough in public, man. I'm always being shamed. I swear it's just my allergies. No need to be contained. Stop messing with me, dog. You don't even know my name.
All these people showing off their face like who asked? Now we gotta go into stores wearing a mask. We're off to 2021, sayonara cowabungus. Trying to find the haters like imposters in Among Us. I used to be a rascal, always getting into trouble. But now I'm stacking paper, call me Mr. Triple Double.
Coronavirus hit us like a train, but we still hit the studio running for the fame. Every day praying 5 times a day, now this dude, Shaitan, out here burning in flames. everybody fighting for paper for their poop. Now I can't go out with the boys to chew some hoops. Whoops, looks like I'm running out of toilet paper. Psych, I'ma use some lotas, buddy. I'ma see you later.
Among Us took off like a flight to Dubai. When Jake Paul met Nate Robinson, he said, "You're gonna die." He wasn't lying, though. He told him, "Bye-bye."
COVID-19 got all these people real talkative. Then they become all quiet when they test positive. I'm so hungry I could use a granola bar, but this pandemic got me riding Corona bars.
Hey, hold up. Prasad, that line was absolutely fire.
Why'd you interrupt me, mate? Are you mad? Are you stupid, innit, bro? You're messing up my flow with your ludicrous tomfoolery. Don't come in here with your dilly-dallying again. You put me in shambles, mate. I'm knackered.
Hey, yo, you're not even British.
When writing this rap, people said to copy Drake, because none of us are Shakespeare. Now look at us. We started from the bottom, now we're here. Police keep treating people wrong, telling them to scatter. But we keep avoiding the main thing, Black Lives Matter. Advocating for equal rights, we cannot be destroyed. Stay woke, everyone, and RIP George Floyd. You go outside and you see a divided nation. We must all unite and do this without hesitation.
Off saying Bismillah Rahman Rahim, and we edited it saying Sadaq Allah Al Ali Al Azim.
First day of C production.
My paddle's keen and bright, flashing with silver. Follow the wild goose flight, dip, dip, and swing. Dip, dip, and swing your bat, flashing with silver. Follow the wild goose fly, dip, dip, and swing. Land of the silver birch, home of the beaver, western the mighty moose wanders at will. Blue lake and rocky shore, I will return once more. Boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom. High on a rocky ledge, I'll build my wigwam. Close to the water's edge, silent and still. Blue lake and rocky shore, I will return once more. Boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom. My heart grows sick for thee, here in the lowlands. I will return to thee, hails of the north. Blue lake and rocky shore, I will return once more. Boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom. Land of the silver birch, home of the beaver, where still the mighty moose wanders at will. Blue lake and rocky shore, I will return once more. Boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom diddy ada, boom.
Give me an S.
S.
Give me a C.
C.
Give me a O.
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 Give me a U.
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 Give me a T.
T.
Give me an S.
S.
What does that spell?
Scout.
This is my third virtual campfire. We had one with our own group, and I attended one in Denmark at the recent Jamboree on the internet. I want to tell you that the performances we've seen so far are the best of the best. You really deserve the cheers.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My name is Razem Aya, and I'm from the First Max Scouts group. This is my buddy Yoshi. He is a djembe canoer, and he is from northeastern Brazil. His normal diet is seeds, nuts, and dried fruits. He also loves snacking on stuff, especially bananas and popcorn. His colors are red, yellow, and a red, yellow, and orange body and head with a green tail and green wings and a black beak. By the way, if you didn't know, he had a tiny bit of blue on his tail. We taught him three tricks. The first trick is push a kiss. Good boy. The second trick is wings. Good boy. The third trick is Yoshi Salam. Assalamu alaikum. Good boy. He loves massages on his neck and beak. That's why every single time he does something cool, I give him a massage. This is a massage on his beak. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Orlando by 13th Burnaby Cubs. Yay!
Can I have some lemonade, please?
Yeah, sure. It's only $5 for one glass.
Here you go.
Thank you. Here's your lemonade.
Enjoy.
This lemonade is amazing. Where did you get it from?
Orlando.
Okay, sounds good. See you soon.
Can I have some lemonade, please?
You sure can. Only $5 for one glass. Thank you. Here's your lemonade.
It's terrific. Where did you get it from?
Orlando.
Okay, I'll be back soon.
Enjoy.
Can I have some lemonade?
Yeah, you sure can. Only $5 for one glass. Thank you. Here you go.
Whoa, this lemonade is so good. Where did you get it from?
Orlando.
Okay, be back soon.
Enjoy.
Can I have some lemonade, please?
Yep, $5 for a glass.
There you go.
Here's a lemonade.
This lemonade is amazing. Where is it from?
Orlando.
Okay, be back soon.
Can I have some lemonade, please?
Yep, $5 a glass. Here's your lemonade.
Wow, it's so good. Where'd you get it from?
Orlando.
I'll be back soon.
Okay.
Can I have some lemonade, please?
Sure, $5.
Okay, here you go.
Here's your lemonade.
It's so good. Where did you get it?
Orlando.
Yeah.
Can I have some lemonade, please?
Sure, only $5.
Yeah.
Here's a lemonade.
So good. Where did you get it from?
Orlando.
Could I get some lemonade, please?
Sure. Only $5.
There you go.
Here's a lemonade.
So good. Where did you get it from?
Orlando.
Day.
Can we please have some lemonade?
Yeah. Sure, but I'm out right now. Let me go get some.
Okay.
Here you go.
Ew, it's so good.
Your dog.
Yeah.
The end.
What did the Cub Scout bake?
What?
Cupcakes.
When is a Cub Scout like a cabinet?
When?
When he is a cupboard.
Where do aliens go after high school?
Where?
University.
What did the salad say to the fridge?
What?
Close the door, I'm dressing.
What are you looking at?
I don't know. I'm just following her. What are you looking at?
I don't know. I'm just following her. What are you looking at?
Oh, my neck just hurts.
Well, Ariba, I'm going to New York with you. You know, Bucky Harris, the Yankees manager, gave me a job as coach for as long as you're on the team.
Look, Manal, if you're the coach, you must know all the players.
I certainly do.
Well, you know I've never met the guys, so you'll have to tell me their names, and then I'll know who's playing on the team.
Oh, I'll tell you their names, but you know, it seems to me they give these ballplayers nowadays very peculiar names.
You mean funny names?
Strange names. Well, let's see, we have on the bags, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
That's what I want to find out.
I said, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know who's on third.
Are you the manager?
Yeah.
You're going to be the coach too?
Yep.
And you don't know the players' names?
Well, I should.
Well, then who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the player's name.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who?
The guy playing.
Who is on first?
I'm asking you who's on first.
That's the man's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Well, go ahead and tell me.
That's it.
That's who?
Yes.
Look, you got a first baseman?
Certainly.
Who's playing first?
That's right.
When you pay off the first baseman every month, who gets the money?
Every dollar of it.
All I'm trying to find out is the player's name on first base.
Who?
The guy that gets...
That's it.
Who gets the money?
He does, every dollar. Sometimes his wife comes down to collect it.
Whose wife?
Yes. What's wrong with that?
Look, all I want to know is, when you sign up the first baseman, how does he sign his name?
Who?
The guy.
Who?
How does he sign?
That's how he signs it.
Who?
Yes.
Ging-gang-gully-gully-gully-gully, whatcha?
Ging-gang-goo, ging-gang-goo.
Shali wali, shali wali, shali wali, shali wali, oompa, 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 oompa.
Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to wrap your necker properly and a bonus. And for a bonus, I'm going to be showing you how to do the friendship knot. So let's get to it. Okay, so first thing you're going to need is a necker. Okay, and another thing you're going to need to do this is two people. So I have Mr. Offman and Mrs. Sama. Now, you guys are going to have to hold this from here. So I need you guys to hold the tips, and you too. Yeah, it was. Okay. And so you guys are going to look for, like, practically the middle, and you're just going to, like, start to roll it pretty tight, even though they're pulling, like, a little bit. They're not pulling that hard, but they're pulling. So don't worry about the shape right now. So once it gets a little bit more, like, to here, you want to let go, please. One, two, three. And now you're going to have them to hold it one more time. Hold it again. And you're going to grab this part, so you left some, and you're just going to pull it like that. And then you're going to do it again. And then you stop at like a small triangle like this, and then you let go. Okay, one, two, three, and then you want to straighten it out, straighten it, and there you go. You got a perfect clean necker. Anyways, so now I'm going to show you how to do the friendship knot. So now you don't need anybody for the friendship knot because it's just the knot. Okay, so number one, you're going to grab one strap and you're going to put it upwards. Not all of it, but like kind of a little bit of it. So you want to put it upwards like this. Then you're going to put the second strap over. And then you go under, so you're going to wrap it around kind of like that. And then you're going to bring this strap. So right now you should be in this type of position, as you can see. So you're going to bring this way. And then you're just going to be this. You're going to bring this part, the top part, bring it that way. And then this here, there you already had a loop here, so you're just going to bring it through the loop. And perfect friendship knot. So you're just going to pull these, and there is your friendship knot. So it's like a square kind of, and that's called a friendship knot. So in this video you guys learned how to make friendship knot and also how to do your necker properly. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Got any duck food?
No, this is a hardware store. We don't sell duck food.
Got any duck food?
No, this is a hardware store. We do not sell duck food.
Got any duck food?
No, no, no. And if you ask me again, I'm going to nail your feet to the floor.
Got any nails?
No.
Got any duck food?
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Rouge Mountains, Chattanooga River.
Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than country roads take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, Mountain Mama, take me home, country roads.
All my memories gather around her, miner's lady. Changes to blue water,
dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, you drop in my eye.
Yesterday, country roads take me home to the place I belong.
Virginia.
Mountain mama.
Take me home, country roads.
We've seen so many great performances tonight. How do you end off a night like this? With gratitude. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we thank our scouters for bravely moving forward, rain or shine or global pandemic, to provide these opportunities for us to learn and grow and shine in our communities. I hope everyone here has a great night.
Assalamu alaikum everyone, how's everything? This is Rashid Hurani, Vice President of Muslim Scouts Fellowship in Canada and manager of MAC Scouts National Program. And I'm here for the closing moments. It was a great 1 hour we spent together. And at the end of this wonderful scouting meeting at this campfire, I would like to remind myself and our beloved scouts that we are all in a great gift from Allah. This is a very good blessing for joining this wonderful scouting movement. How wonderful it is for us to be brothers and sisters in Islam. And in Scouts Brotherhood, Scouts movement brought us together. Allah said in Quran, the believers are brothers. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, a Muslim is a brother of all other Muslims. In scouting, the portal layers, whether it is a layer or a portal or an expedition for ventures, this system is a practical reflection of the spirit of brotherhood. At the principle, all the principles of Scouts urge us to cooperate, work as a team, help each other, respect the old, and be mercy for the youngers. All are related to the brotherhood in Islam, alhamdulillah. Have a good night and sleep well. Please don't forget to make dua and pray for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep all Muslims safe from COVID-19, so that we can return to the great outdoor adventures and activities and enjoy our wonderful scouting programs together as a brother in Islam and scouting. The leaders here are preparing a wonderful camp for all that for all of you. And we want to bring all of you together in one camp or jamboree. So be there, inshallah, once we are ready to start. Thank you very much. Have a good night. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya.
Someone's praying.